Hello, welcome, and thank you very much for stopping by my poster. My name is Thomas Wilschut, and I'm from the University of Groningen. Today, I will tell you something about our work on visual working memory, attention, and color categories. Let's start with the background of this project. This study is based on two recent findings. First, the finding that visual working memory for color is biased by color categories. So this means that colors are typically remembered as more prototypical to the category they belong to than they actually are. Second, we used the recent findings that it is possible to infer the visual saliency of certain stimulus from pupil size. Now, this was done by two researchers in recent years. First, Binda and colleagues in 2015 found that attended stimuli compared to unattended stimuli elicit stronger pupil constrictions. Second, almost Solis and colleagues found that stimuli that match the color of an item that is maintained in visual working memory actually elicit a longer pupil constriction compared to non-matching stimuli. So these are two distinct ways to infer the visual saliency, so the extent to which a stimulus captures attention, from pupil size. So let's move on to the aims of the current project. So here we aim to combine the two previously mentioned findings to examine color category effects on visual working memory using pupillometry and visual saliency. So the aims of this study are twofold. The first aim is to replicate the results of Binda and colleagues and of Almost Solis and colleagues in order to find out how pupil responses reflect the visual salience of a stimulus. Second, we will use this knowledge in order to examine how color categories modulate these pupil responses and behavioral color reproductions. In order to answer these questions, we asked 30 participants to remember a certain color. During the attention interval, a probe was presented to the participants. Crucially, this probe could be of four different types. First, it could be an exact match of the item that was maintained in memory. Second, it could be a little bit different from the item maintained in memory, but in the same verbal color category, in this case, green. Third, it could be equally different from the memory item as the within category item, but then in another color category, in this case, yellow. And finally, it could be opposite to the remembered color, in this case, purple. Pupil constrictions in response to these different probes were measured and compared. Let's move on to the results. In the upper left corner, a comparison of pupil constrictions for completely new different stimuli and exact memory matching stimuli is shown. And interestingly, we found here that pupil responses show a stronger initial constriction in response to new or opposite stimuli compared to memory matching stimuli. On the upper right of the screen, you see the comparison of between categories versus exact match stimuli. So here we have slightly different probes versus exact matching probes. And here we find that there is a prolonged pupil constriction to stimuli that actually match the content of visual working memory. The lower left panel shows the comparison of within category and between category probes. Here we find no difference. So this means that there is no effect of color categories on pupil responses. The lower right panel shows behavioral response scores. Here we see that behavioral responses are systematically drawn towards color category centers. So there seems to be an effect of color categories, but only on the behavioral level and not on the pupil size level. For our first research question about visual saliency and pupil size, two main conclusions can be drawn. First, we found stronger initial pupil constriction for completely new stimuli. And these effects may be explained using adaptation. For completely new stimuli, the participants did not have the time to adapt, and therefore, completely new stimuli may be visually more salient than memory matching stimuli. Later in time, we found an opposite effect, namely that there is a longer constriction for memory matching stimuli versus memory non-matching stimuli. Together, these results imply that adaptation and memory-driven capture together determine the visual saliency of the stimulus, and that these affect early and late components of the pupil response respectively. At the level of the pupil size, color categories did not affect memory-driven captures, even though behavioral responses were biased significantly by color categories in the same task. The behavioral results found in this study underline that categorical biases may be an important characteristic of visual perception and visual working memory. However, the fact that we did not find any differences in pupil size implies that they may not affect all levels of visual processing equally. If you found this work interesting, you can scan the QR code below, which will take you to a more detailed description of the study. Please do not hesitate to get in contact if you have any questions. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye.